delivering quality education, expanding access to learning, serving learners' learning needs, tackling challenges of the present time, supporting every learner's dream, reaching young Tagumbenos where they are today. From the music capital of the Philippines, advancing in the challenge of distance learning. Bringing you quality education straight to your home. Plug yourself in. This is DepEd TV. Tara na!
It is an honor to be here with you today, grade 11 and 12 learners. Front office department plays a critical function in a hotel, and it is the face of a hotel or hospitality establishment. It is the first and the last department where a guest interacts, and it is the responsibility of the front office department to establish first-hand experiences of the quality of services and facilities offered by the hotel. Welcome to week 7 of quarter 2. What a great day from Lantau Compre, our school on air, through television. The television-based instruction of DepEd of Tagum City Division. I am your teacher, Ruth T. Hativa, from Tagum City National Comprehensive High School. So today, let us start the day right by having a good attitude towards learning. This is the Front Office Services Institute Delivery Mode module on completing routine records and reports. May this provide you with fun and meaningful opportunities for guided and independent learning as you watch and process the contents that will lead right before your very eyes. Are you excited to know more today's lesson? I bet you are, so let's get it on. For this episode, you are expected to first, complete routine records and reports accurately within designated timelines. Second, forward reports promptly to the appropriate person or department. Before we head on, prepare your pen, paper, and your module. Then try to read and answer this activity in page 6 of your self-learning module. Choose the correct answer inside the box or the correct word that corresponds to your answer. You will be given 5 seconds to answer. Question number 1. This is a room and tax report list of all your room revenue and associated taxes for the day. The correct answer is room and tax report. Question number 2. The report includes a breakdown of every transaction sold by category and item. The correct answer is Chief Audit Report. Question number 3. This report shows who was scheduled to leave your property today and who will be leaving the next day. The correct answer is departure report. Question number 4. This report includes the list of arrivals for the upcoming day and includes basic information. The correct answer is arrivals report. Question number 5. The report helps you identify which guests have been assigned rooms and those who have not. The correct answer is room type book. Great job, senior high school learners! Now, let me ask you, have you been in a hotel? Have you come across with a front desk officer? Or have you tried to be a cashier in your parents' or relatives' businesses? What did you do? This time, let us know more about them. Running a hotel property of any size is no easy deed. Small and medium-sized property owners are in charge of manually creating reports every day, keeping tracks of revenue, reservations, and inventory can be a handful. But reporting is necessary to make your life as a hoteler easier in the long run. There are different areas of responsibilities a front desk officer must distinguish, and this includes the types of reports one will render. First, we have the room and tax report. This report is room and tax report list of all your room revenue associated taxes for the day. This is start by pulling all the revenue and taxes to know exactly how much money is coming into the hotel each day. This report is to identify potential issues like departures, arrivals, continuous report to make sure the revenue falls within a normal range for the hotel current occupancy. If you decide not to do this report, you could run into several problems, like someone forgot to check out but the revenue posted. It will cause accounting problems later. Instead of having to make an accounting adjustment in the future, you can catch it immediately and reduce confusion by doing of room and tax report daily. Second is the chief audit report. Each cashier or user needs a chief audit report at the end of the day or their shift. The report includes breakdown of every transaction sold by category and item. It should include a breakdown of payment methods, includes cash, credit card, neither MasterCard, Visa card, and other means. The purpose of this report is to check and balance each revenue and cost source. This should be used for each agent to balance their daily shift. When you create a shift audit report, you need to include cashier or user ID, category department breakdown, payment type breakdown. Third is the departures report. A departures report shows who was scheduled to leave your property today and who will be leaving the next day. Every night, your night manager or auditor should create 2 departure reports, one for the present day and one for the next day. The present day departures will show everyone who was supposed to check out that day. This will help you to identify any guests that did not check out and identify other potential issues such as our bookings. The next day departure report helps you stop prepare for the next day's departures. Your front desk needs to know which rooms will be vacant and available for the incoming reservations, and cleaning staff will need to take the necessary step to prepare the room. Each report should include the following: room assignment, reservation and confirmation number, guest name, arrival date, departure date, room status, neither it is in-house or checkout. Fourth, we have the housekeeping report. The housekeeping report shows the property's room number, front desk status, housekeeping status, departure date, and unit time. This enables the front desk and the housekeeping staff to know which room must be cleaned when. Housekeepers need to know which rooms are being checked out of so they can replace the sheets, towels, toiletries, etc. Without this report, properties run the risk of not having clean rooms that cause check-in delays. Also, if guests have not checked out by the designated time, housekeepers will know to contact the front desk and get the problem sorted out. Fifth is the room type book. The report helps you identify which guests have been assigned rooms and those who have not. You need to make sure that the assigned rooms will be opened and checked in, and identify where an assigned guest will stay. This is when having a departure report comes in handy. Use the departure report to ensure the arrivals list match up and make necessary changes. Sixth is the cashier's report. It is the detailed list of cashier's activity of cash flow and credit cards and PMS totals. It is very important part of the financial control system of a hotel. The front office manager reviews the night audit and looks for any divergences between the actual amount received and the PMS totals. In the services industry, one must be acquainted that a cashier is not just someone who receives money and the like, but also must do some reports like the following: forms of payments, billing procedures, cash handling guidelines, handling bills by credits, and payments by checks. There are three common forms of payment. First, cash. It is the most acceptable form of payment, but it is not practical for tourists and travelers considering the high volume of cash to carry. Second, credit card. This is the most acceptable and desired form of payment in the modern world. It may be operated manually by filling up by the cashier and signature by the guest. In places where there are swipe machines that connected through the internet and it is charged automatically debited. Third, bill to company or direct billing. This is to establish procedures for the approval of bill to company or direct billing privileges for a company or travel agent. To further know about some of the procedures for handling direct bill accounts, continue reading your module in page 13 to 15. The second important thing you must also know is the standard front office billing instructions. Billing or payment instructions are used to display the billing method of a reservation for the front desk staff and cashiers. It is a clear instruction of billing that will help both the front desk staff to do a current settlement of the guest account in the future. The third one is the cash handling guidelines. Large sums of money should be kept within the safe lock and with a time delay lock installed in it and handled out on sight of the general public. Individuals should keep working cash into funds to a minimum at all times. Excess funds should be kept safe in the cashier's office and or deposited it to the bank. The custodian of every cash fund is responsible for the integrity of the cash fund. These policies and guidelines are for the protection not only of the hotel monies but also those employees in charge with cash handling. Now you know what are the important details when it comes to money and how to take care of money, but how money really matters. In different industries, businesses, and transactions, all revolves around money. Money in any form, including currency, coins, and bills, check, wire transfer, credit card charge, direct deposit, other electronic funds transfers, and etc. also refers to a cash or cash receipts. All incoming monies should be acknowledged by receipt with accepted or received and forwarded the cashier's office for processing within one business day. Cash receipts record form to indicate where the funds should be deposited. Money should never be unattended. This applies to cash registers, desktop, and cash drawers. If an employee leaves his or her workstation for any reason, regardless of how briefly, cash must be appropriately secured in a locked place. An authorized person should not be allowed in areas where cash is handled. Doors should always be locked in areas where cash is handled. Large sums of cash should be counted and handled out of sight of the public. Cash funds should always be into a minimum limit. Cash receipt must not be used for making change, petty cash purposes, etc. Expenditures or refunds cannot be made from cash receipts. Way to go! It seems you are fully aware in the responsibilities in the front desk office and its premises. Before we end our session, I would like you to answer the following questions. Number 1. Why it is very important for the front office department to render reports every day? Number 2. What are those forms of cash settlement and how does it process? Number 3. Why we need to save keep the money out of the sights of the public? And that concludes of today's episode of Lantau Compre TV School on Air. Continue reading and answering your module on page 17 to 30 for the rest of our topics like the currency counterfeit detection and handling bills by credit. Once again, this is your teacher, Ruth D. Hativa. Always remember that hospitality is simply an opportunity to show love and care. And according to James Cash, Penny, courteous treatment will make a customer a walking advertisement. Be it in your heart that money is not everything in life. Some might believe that it is impossible to live without money, but be reminded also that there is no amount of money that can buy real love, happiness, and respect. That's it. Good day and God bless.